Zen. This video is about Zen. More specifically, how Zen changed a chronically 5th to 8th place team with the odd overperformance here and there into the best team in the world, and helped lead them into 5 RLCS tournament victories in a row, including the World Championship. How he changed the team from a classic air dribble across the field into a 50-50 stack playstyle, into the highly adaptable, highly linked machine that it is today. But before we start, did you know that almost 92% of you aren't subscribed? This is part 2 of the Roster Mania retrospective miniseries, where we go over roster moves that happened before the summer split of RLCS and see just how that worked out for them. Now that Gamers 8 has proven that Zen is in fact mortal and fallible, now is a better time than ever to talk about Team Vitality and their incredible transformation. Like I mentioned, Vitality started out the 22-23 season of RLCS as a very stereotypical team of air dribbles, flip resets, and ball-chasing 50-50s akin to the North American teams we see getting constantly crushed by European teams at every RLCS. While stacked offense still has its merits and is an effective counter to some other styles, it was and still is not up to the task of defeating the best of Europe. The rest of the video will contain playstyle graphs that are derived from a machine learning algorithm that I wrote that classifies playstyles in Rocket League. The graphs show how close each player is to the average of each style, and there's an endless sea of information that can be derived from these when you know what to look for. I'll point out everything relevant that you need to know, and more information about how I make these can be found in the description. An interesting observation of pre-Zen Vitality is that they actually had their best tournament placements when the team played more defensively. If you remember the video that I made on NRG at the end of last year, they were having the same results with their stack playstyle in North America. The more offensive they tried to play, the more they got punished for overextending and the more that they lost. If they played defensively and utilized quick counterattacks, they could earn a better placement if they were playing solid that day. Vitality's best placement, second place in the Winter Open, had them beating Carmine Corp in Game 5 of their group stage match, but they were unable to carry that into the finals against the same team, losing out 4-1. Carmine, when playing against Vitality in that tournament, played a similarly defensive rotation, but you can see that the player styles more closely align with each other, overlapping roles and leaving less opportunities for Vitality to strike at them. Their 4 quarterfinal finishes show them playing in a very consistent manner, all having their separate, specialized roles on the field. After most of the top European teams adopted variants of BDS's midfield-dominant Cover 2 playstyle from the previous season, Vitality's individualistic playstyle was just not cutting it. Even with a player as good as Zen entering the roster, a continuation of that style would have continued to nerf the team for time immemorial as the rest of the world continued evolving around them. Given Zen's reputation as one of the most mechanical players and beating every top 1v1 player in the world except for Wass, I thought that's exactly what was going to happen. Thankfully, I was very wrong. Against everybody's expectations, Zen played his first tournament in the spring split out of the spotlight, only doing what his team needed of him and nothing more.
Gonna win this, they've done it! In their first regional with Zen, they are the champions of Europe. The future is now!
If we take a look at their playstyles in the previous tournament, Sizen played the roles of anchor and third man while Alpha and Radosin played offensive midfield, starting that team transition into how we see them now. When Zen took over in the next tournament, he filled that role that Sizen left behind, plus a little bit more midfield, and the average playstyle of the team was almost identical to their previous showing. Alpha and Radosin both played more reserved, and the higher cohesiveness of the team allowed them to secure their first tournament victory of the season. In the Spring Cup, we saw Vitality's playstyle continue to transform. Radosin moved further up in the rotation, scoring highest in every stat except assists, while Zen stayed parked in the middle third and Alpha in the defensive third compared to their teammates. Zen took on a heavy playmaker role and was incredibly successful at doing so. At 0.81 assists per game and 1.1 assists per goal, this was by far the best performance he had in this regard before continuing to move further up the rotation for his team. Carmine Corp was very competitive with them in the finals and got the bracket reset, but Vitality was able to make the adjustments after the break and close out the tournament with a 4-2 victory.
Holy Team Vitality, they go back to back. Vatira says GG's deserved, and the new Kings have well and truly cemented their spot right at the top.
The Spring Invitational is where Zen took his final form as an offensive threes demon, as we expected him to do from the get-go, flexing his astronomical game IQ and scoring insane goals. He continued to spend most of the time compared to his team in the middle third, but tended to have a more offensive focus on his ball touches. Alpha moved upfield with him while Redosin took the third man role in this tournament and would continue to do so through the World Championship. While Team BDS was able to keep each game in the final series close, they still were only able to win one game against Vitality. Vitality kept them on their heels and forced them to play a lot of the series on defense. This is the graph of BDS's playstyle in that final series, where Vitality was able to secure their third tournament victory in a row. At this point, Zen had proven himself as the indisputable triple threat, able to defend, play midfield, and attack on offense. But this is where, despite their clear success, I start to worry for the future success of Team Vitality. They of course went on to dominate the Boston Major and then World shortly after, winning a first ever 5 RLCS tournaments in a row, but they did so by Zen continuing to take more and more possession of the ball and the important touches while Alpha and Redosin played more of a support role for him. And that's not to take away from how amazing all of those players are, because it was clearly the most effective way to play and win against the rest of the world. Nobody else stood a chance. If you want a close look into the decision-making and micro-game that Vitality used to be so dominant, I highly recommend checking out Danger Taco's video on their series against BDS in the Grand Finals of Worlds.
Knowing when to go back and let a clear breathe and when to send it back. Zen down the middle, knowing Rado can chase a 50. Alpha immediately follows, but only to try to spike the ball in the ceilings. Zen is rotating up, but specifically rolls to the far side to send the clear high. BDS is back far and unable to immediately reach. No goal on this run, but sequences like this show why BDS struggles to get into offense. Ultimately, the scoreline holds at 1-0.
Check out the rest on his channel, linked in the description. But I am concerned that the over-reliance on one player's continued dominance will make the team's playstyle come full circle into an individualistic rotation where one guy tries to out-mechanic the other team 3-on-1 and the other two just do their best to keep the ball in play. It's effective when that guy is the most mechanical in the world, but what happens when everyone else starts to catch up? We don't even need to look that far into the past to see what it looks like when that happens. Remember when RLCSX NRG went into the following season where, despite some good performances, they struggled to stay in the top 8 in their own region, let alone the world stage? I think that we could see a repeat of history starting to happen already if Team Vitality doesn't course correct. Take a look at the difference between pre-Zen and post-Zen playstyles on Team Vitality and see just how different it is when everybody works together as one cohesive unit. When that breaks down, I can see it going back to where they started before the roster move. Even though it isn't purely a threes tournament, we saw in Gamers 8 that Zen and Vitality are not invincible, and Team Vitality will continue to struggle against the rising crop of talent like Rule 1 if they get too comfortable in their current style of over-reliance on Zen and his mechanics. Yeah, I know they just lost their first tournament ever and still placed high in the standings, and I know it's a stretch to compare Gamers 8 to RLCS given the formats, but I don't think it's crazy to extrapolate this pattern into something that we've already seen before. Hot take. I know. Don't get me wrong, I still think that Team Vitality will continue to place at the top of every tournament next season, so we'll see how the rest of the world adapts to them and how long it takes. Team Vitality may be a dynasty now, but it never lasts forever. I don't say breaks, I've been in my bag.